Hi there. My name is Sevag Demirjian. This presentation is part of an educational series about kidney medicine and extracorporeal support. Enjoy. With kidney failure, we typically are focused on electrolytes and urea creatinine that build up. However, it's important to realize that there are a lot of toxins and solutes that build up in several hundreds, in fact. And not all small solutes behave the same way. For example, phosphorus is compartmentalized and it's harder to remove than urea is, even though they have very similar weight. And some others are protein-bound, like p-cresol and indoxyl sulfate, and they're not removed by dialysis at all. And of course, there's also metamolecules, which are much bigger than your electrolytes and urea. And these are typically exemplified by beta-2 microglobulin, which sits in that 12,000 Dalton range and has been associated with amyloidosis. And now the current high-flux dialyzers, which are used most in our chronic and acute patients, actually do a fair job of removing these metamolecules, especially in convection mode rather than diffusion mode. Now, most dialyzers stop at albumin of 67,000 molecular weight and try not to leak during dialysis. But of course, there are bigger proteins as well. If you look at the distribution of proteins in your plasma, they range many of them in that 30,000-40,000, but they can extend all the way to 1,000 kilodaltons. And of course, if you compare small molecules and to the size of a pigeon, those proteins are weight-wise as comparable to an elephant. Next, let's talk about filters. Sieving coefficient is the measure of equilibration of a substance through a semipermeable membrane. For example, urea has a sieving coefficient of 1. You would hope your dialyzer has a very low sieving coefficient for albumin, so you don't leak albumin to the other side. Low-flux dialyzers are good for small solute clearance, but not so much for metamolecules. The newer, medium cutoff dialyzers expand on the high flux in their ability to clear metamolecules, but still fall short of what a native kidney does, especially when you factor in the dynamic nature of solute handling with a la carte use of secretion and absorption of essential solutes as needed. The main determinant of a particular dialyzer's handling of solutes is the pore size distribution, with low flux membranes having low ultrafiltration coefficient, typically less than 15 mLs per millimercury per hour, such as the cellulose or cuprophane-based membranes. Whereas the high flux and the medium cutoff membranes have larger pores, with the medium cutoffs having narrow distribution of large pores. Let's take a closer look at the dialyzer, specifically the hollow fibers inside. There are many variations in the synthetic material used in manufacturing these fibers. Some have asymmetric walls, such as this one, where most of the sieving occurs in the narrow innermost part, and most of the outer shell is a supportive structure. An important byproduct of the use of membranes with larger pores is its implications on the quality of dialysis water used. For there's a significant internal filtration and backfiltration that occurs with high flux membranes, and more so with medium cutoff ones. Blood flows within the fibers and dialysate around the fibers. Within the filter, due to countercurrent flow of blood and dialysate. Pressure is highest within the fiber at the blood entry side. In a membrane with a high UF coefficient, you will have significant filtration at the blood entry side above and beyond the UF prescribed. And because of volumetric control, the equivalent amount of dialysate will go to the patient on the blood outlet side where external dialysate pressure is higher. The internal filtration back filtration can be enhanced by reducing the hollow fiber diameter, where you have higher pressure buildup for the same blood flow rate. It can also be increased by using longer fibers. Another method to achieve higher rates of internal convection is the use of pulse push-pull dialysis, where blood and dialysate flow are stopped in turn out of phase to favor internal filtration and back filtration. Hope you enjoyed the presentation.